Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to this channel. My name is Juan from Web Design DNS, and today I will be talking about Wix Events Hub and how to create an event which someone can register for within Wix. Now let's get into today's video.
Web Design DNS, center of health, find us every time, everywhere.
Okay, for creating events, manage them, collecting RVPs, selling tickets, promoting your events, checking your guest list and communicating with them, you can use Wix Event. When you create events, there is a few ways that you can take it, right? If you need to create your own site for one event, you click on Create New Site. Click on Event. Click on Choose a Template. For my example, I'll use this Tech Conference. So I click on Edit. So you can create events for a public sector, or it can be private event where it's just collecting RVPs, or you can create corporate events, then you may need tickets. So you can have weddings, birthday parties, conference, meetups, workshop, anything you really need, you can use events for that. So you need to choose the right template for your event. Now, when you create your own site for one event, you need to search the Buy Ticket button. For managing your events and setting another issues with respect to Wix Events Hub, and I'll show you in this video. Or if you already have your own site on Wix and you want to implement the Wix Event Hub on your website, you can also add the Wix Event Hub. For this example, I will show you how to add the Wix Event app for a different site. Okay, so click on My Sites. Click on Create New Site. Click on Others. Click on Choose a Template. Click on Blank Templates. Click on the first option. Click on Edit. Now, to add the Wix Event app, all we need to want to do is scroll over here to Add Apps. And then we click on Add Apps. It's going to open up the Wix app market. And then we're going to type in the search box Wix Events. And you'll see Wix Events. It's an app by Wix. You click on that. And this open up the dashboard that explains to use the overview, the features, the reviews, the developer info, all the cool stuff. So in case you don't know about the Wix Event app and you want to know about it, you can read this. Then you click on Add to Site. And this is automatically going to add the events app to our page. So the first thing that you want to do, of course, is manage your event. So click on Manage Event. And that's going to take you to the dashboard. You're able to either your event and edit an existing event. Okay. Manage Events. As you can see, This is the same, manage and configure. Now I will explain in this tab and it will be the same. And this is all the magic is going to happen. So we're going to fill in all of our details. Okay, for this example, I will show you with this event. So would you give it a name and can you give it a short teaser? And you can also add a beautiful image by clicking here and it will take it to your media library. You're going to fill it up your date and time, and you can also add an end date and end time if you want to put your time zone. And if you don't know this information, click on TBD as to be determined. And if you want to put your location, there is two ways: physical address and online. Physical address, for example, San Francisco. And online can be, for example, a webinar or online workshops or whatever you want to show on your online event. Okay, the next section is video conference. This is optional if you want to connect with your Zoom or another platform. And about your event, this is optional as well. You can put more information about your event, then you're going to save. Okay, close. Now, let's go with tickets. Now, in order to create tickets, you click on tickets. Scroll down, and you want to say guest starter. You need to choose your ticket name here. For example, golden ticket. Your description, for example, this is the golden ticket. And if you scroll down here, you can do two options. The first option is to have the ticket for sale, and then you can see your price per ticket and your currency. And if you want, you can choose your limit quality. I mark this and you can see your price per ticket, for example, $25, and your currency. And if you want, you can choose your limit quality. Maybe you only want 25 people. I will say 20 people here. And the second option is tickets for free here. Okay, the next section is the tickets policy that comes with Wix already. Okay, click on save. And if you will scroll down, you can add new tickets right here. Okay, now if you want to change your currency or add tax, you click on edit over here. And here you could change your currency here, or you can add tax here, or select your tax name and tax rate. And if you scroll down, you can select the ticket limit. For example, if you want to only want 20 tickets, it's my limit of tickets. And finally, save. Okay, get out. Right. Now, let's go with register settings. I click on edit. Now, here you can choose where your guests register, on your own page or a different page, or if you don't want to register for your guests. And you can choose when your register is open or when your register is closed. Okay, click on save. And then you come back, can customize the register form. So click on edit. And if you scroll down, you can change your register form. The title, and you can ask about the information that you need for this form. If you need to add more options, you can add more options right here. And this is the preview form. Okay, you click on save. And then you come back, you can also manage your event policies and register message. Here, if you want to add policies, you can do. Okay, now emails. There is a couple default emails that people will be received: the confirmation email, the reminder email, and the cancellation email. And obviously you can edit right here. Okay, I click on edit. Then you come in here, you can change your subject here, the message, down below the details, and you can add links, and you can also watch the overview to write. Okay, so click on save and that's it. Okay, now let's go with orders. Okay guys, now orders. Once guests buy tickets to your event, you will see the orders information of them here. But now I need to create your invitations, and then you'll need to send the invitations. Okay, here you can create your invitation. Choose your template and you create your invitation, right? Okay, closed. Okay, finally, guest list. And here, this is similar. When your guest buy tickets, you'll see their information here. And you can create invitation and you can also add guest manual here. And here you need to fill in the details of the guest, for example the name, last name and email, and the details of the tickets. Okay, save. Awesome. Now I can go into settings for my event. So you have the complete the control to customer, the look and feel for your event. And you can come in here, click on settings. You can come here in my events and you can show multiple events or a single event. If you have multiple events, you can show only events that you want, and you can choose the layout. How do you like to show your events? Okay, display. Here, what do you show your information, right? And text. Text, if you want to customize the text of your event. And finally, design. For customer, the text design, the bottom design, the background and spelling. Okay, close. So that's it. If this video helped you, hit the like button. If you like videos like this in general, hit the subscribe button. Join to our Facebook page. We have Instagram and Twitter, and if you have any issues with your site, you can also explore our website webdesign.dns. All of them in the description below. Okay guys, this is all for this video. Take care and I see you in the next video.